weather from where you live.
We continue to be dominated by the polar jet. This is where all the clippers are located, and all the deep moisture is in the subtropical jet south of our area. So again, like we've been saying, it's split flow, but where the two merge, you get big storms. And we've got a weak disturbance here, a weak clipper just to our north that won't have much effect on us. Then a decent system south of here with a lot of moisture, and the two will link up, and we're looking at a big nor'easter on the east coast. Notice the winter storm warnings in effect all along the east coast. A good 8 to 12 inch snow over a lot of this area. Some places, parts of Massachusetts up to Maine, will get 20 inches of snow from this system. But our system is way on the Pacific Northwest. It's an Alberta clipper. It's going to come in and bring some rain and snow Sunday, then changing to all snow with time Sunday, and the snow will end by Monday morning. Windy tomorrow, but also windy during that system on Sunday and Monday. Even though the snow will be wet and gloppy, it'll still blow and drift at least a little bit Sunday night into Monday with minor accumulations expected. Tomorrow, upper 30s for most of the area from Remington, Morocco, Delphi, Logansport to Kokomo, the 36 at Rochester, 41 degrees at Lafayette, and 41 at Thorntown. On Sunday, these numbers will tend to occur fairly early in the day. Then the temp's going to fall pretty quickly to near freezing with time. 41 Lafayette, 35 Morocco as the cold air comes in, 38 at Logansport. On Precision Futurecast, notice still a lot of clouds tonight. We may get some holes here and there with lows dropping into the mid-20s. And then quite a few clouds tomorrow. Notice the clock here right through tomorrow afternoon. Perhaps a few holes here and there, but by and large, a lot of low clouds still kind of hanging on with a pretty stiff southwest wind. Then some rain and snow start to come in on Sunday, and eventually it will tend to change to all snow with time, especially as we go later on into the day. And then by Monday morning, the back edge of the snow exiting, and we'll get at least a little bit of sun. Still looks like the best potential of significant snow just northeast of our viewing area, right in here where we could get 6 inches, more minor snowfall in our area. So you can see with our map here up towards the Warsaw area and also Wabash 4 to 6. 2 to 4 Logansport, up to Winnemac, Rochester, Peru, near Grissom Air Reserve Base. 1 to 2 Lafayette, Rensselaer, Frankfort, Fowler, Chalmers, and then an inch or less Crawfordsville, Vetersburg, up towards Attica, and also West Lebanon. Of course, Amber will be monitoring this throughout the weekend. There's potential for this to shift a little bit. Pretty tedious forecast. Then another clipper comes in with some snow Wednesday, and then mixed rain and snow by Thursday. But a lobe of cold comes in early in the week, then it warms up briefly, and then a more potent chunk of cold comes in late in the week. And then after that, we'll watch. We could have a pretty decent winter weather system around the 1st of February and quite a bit of cold air behind that one. So bottom line is more wintry, better chances of getting some accumulating snow as we end January and move right into early February.
All right. Well, it's good to be thinking about the beginning of February, though, isn't it?
Thank goodness.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, Jim.
Sure.
Got the frenzy.